Hi, I'm Nadia Gill.
And I'm Brett Malik. Welcome to Game Time. We are live from Mardi Gras Restaurant here in downtown San Bernardino. And now,
it's time to get our game on. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, and thanks for joining us here on Game Time, where we have a fantastic show lined up for you tonight on our maiden voyage.
Indeed. We begin this epic journey live from Mardi Gras Restaurant, where you'll find friendly service with a smile and some great tasting authentic Southern cooking to go with it.
All right, tonight we have a great show lined up for all of you. First, we'll be visiting with Arroyo Valley Baseball skipper Ray Gallardo. Later, we'll also get a chance to visit with Isaac Marquez from the Arroyo Valley baseball team.
Next up, we'll head over to Arrowhead Credit Union Park and take a look at the new alliance that took place right down the street at the Inland Empire's affiliation celebration with the 66ers.
And that's not all, folks. We've got an action-packed show for you with our Game Time Profile of the Week. You won't want to miss that one, and all this will be followed up with our Matchups of the Week.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we are launching this wonderful sports show on one of the biggest nights in college basketball as the University of Connecticut battles Butler University for the NCAA Division I Basketball Championship. So in honor of tonight's game, we would like to start our recap by congratulating this year's high school basketball CIF champions.
Yes, we'd like to take a minute and congratulate all of this year's high school basketball programs that lived in their very own championship moment.
We begin with girls Division V champs, and that's Pinewood School from Los Altos Hills in Northern California. And the boys Division V championship belongs to St. Joseph Notre Dame in Alameda. Congratulations to both of them.
Now, Brett, the Division IV CIF basketball championship brought something pretty special. You want to know what that was?
Pretty sure you're going to tell me right now.
That's right. I'm going to tell you the Division IV championship brought out the broom as Windward School in Los Angeles swept up the championship trophies for both the boys and girls basketball teams. Big congratulations to Windward High School for their amazing basketball teams.
That's a great accomplishment, and something tells me you should not put that broom away, at least not yet.
There's more sweeping to be done?
There is, but not in Division III, because the CIF Girls Basketball Championship belongs to St. Joseph High School in Santa Maria, and the Boys Division III Championship belongs to Lutheran High School in Laverne, so congratulations to our neighbors in the West.
And Brett, the Division II championship also hit very close to home. We had some neighbors in the hunt, but unfortunately they came up a bit short. This year's Division II girls basketball championship belongs to St. Mary's High School from Stockton, California, who defeated Rialto High School, and on the boys' side, Archbishop Mitty High School from San Jose, California, defeated our other neighbors at Summit High School in Fontana. It's great to see our neighbors fighting for that championship. Congratulations to everyone for their great seasons.
Yeah, I agree. Those are great seasons. Now, Nadia, you remember that broom that I told you not to put away?
Is it time?
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. The Division I CIF basketball championship for both boys and girls belongs to Modern Day High School from Santa Ana. Congratulations to Modern Day and their tremendous achievement, and to all high schools for their great seasons. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, that is your Game Time recap of the week.
We'll be right back with the Coach's Corner right here on Game Time.
When you come to Mardi Gras, we want you to feel like you really are experiencing the Mardi Gras when you come here. Mardi Gras offers good food, good entertainment, and wonderful customer service. Mardi Gras is the home of the ultimate Cajun cuisine, and anything you can find in New Orleans, we try to accommodate that here. Our menu consists of breakfast, lunch, and dinner, which is served all day. We have fried fish, grilled fish, and we also have frog legs. We offer different types of Cajun rice, dirty rice, gumbo, jambalaya. Those are like the main dishes that most of our customers come in for. What gives Mardi Gras the ultimate Cajun cuisine is our head chef. Everything is made from scratch, so everything you order is going to have its own unique flavor. Every Friday here at Mardi Gras, we offer an all-you-can-eat fish. We call it our Fish Lovers Friday, and that's one of our most popular days because people love the catfish. Mardi Gras is a happy place. Every ethnic group enjoys our food. We're family friendly. It's a fun environment. Everyone just absolutely loves it. Mardi Gras has offered me an opportunity to be able to do something that I've always loved. I love the customers that come visit us every day. I enjoy seeing people enjoy our food. We're located at 201 Northeast Street, Suite 101, 909-884-5000. So come on in and enjoy the great taste of New Orleans and stick around for the live entertainment.
Welcome back, everyone, and a very special welcome to our very special first guest here on Game Time from Arroyo Valley High School baseball coach Ray Gallardo. And coach, thanks for coming on today.
Thanks for having me.
What do you think so far?
Wow, this is a pretty cool place. Reminds me of Bourbon Street.
A little bit of New Orleans. Coach, before we get into talking about today's game and this season, we want to get to that in just a moment. We wanted to ask you, though, when you were a player, was there a coach that had an impact on you, not only as an athlete, but as an individual?
Yeah, I definitely have to say my dad was a big influence in my life. Both my folks, they did a lot of things just to get me to practice, and, you know, they'd wait and stand in the car for long periods of time and just wait till my whole practice was over. Sometimes practice were 2 hours, 3 hours long. And so they were kind of an inspiration for me as a, you know, and a big role model growing up. And I always thank them as often as I can for taking the time to be a part of baseball, especially for kids today.
And what's your favorite part of coaching,
you would say? You know, my favorite part of coaching definitely has to be watching a player develop. Over the years, you get to see kids that they start out as ninth graders. And, you know, maybe they're a little bit rough, but you see the potential. And over time, you get to see them develop. And it's really rewarding by the time they get to senior year to see them shine and watch them go off and succeed and be successful.
Well, Coach, the team has not had a solid start to this season. You're coming off some losses in the county clash. What do you think can start a turnaround, and what are you telling your players right now about what's happened so far?
Well, one of the things that I'm telling the players is to keep their head up, to maintain focus, and to you know, take it one game at a time. You know, it's really easy to you know, sit there and really kind of beat yourself up about, you know, what went wrong and things that you could do better. But the phrase that we like to use on our team is water off a duck's back, and try and shake it off and to get back after it. And so hopefully we can right the ship. We're doing the right things in practice, and I'm starting to see some of the younger players come up and really develop and showcase some of their abilities, and it takes a little time.
Okay. And so how's the overall health of the team?
Well, that's been one of the big things of you know, one of our pitfalls this year. We're nursing a lot of injuries. I got four players that are out because of injuries early on, a couple in practice, a couple in games, and a couple just life-related. So hopefully we'll get some of those guys back and get them healthy again, and it'll translate into some wins for us.
Yeah, you always want to have a healthy team, but yeah, once you get it full strength, you feel like, hey, now the season really begins.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, that sounds great. Good luck on this season, and thanks for coming on Game Time, Coach Gallardo.
All right, I really appreciate it. Thank you for your time.
All right, don't go away. We'll be right back with Isaac Marquez from Arroyo Valley Baseball.
Welcome to Access Rewind.
Access Rewind will be taping each of our shows in the field at select locations all over the Inland Empire, bringing you unrestricted behind-the-scenes access and revealing interesting and unknown facts about each location.
Access Rewind, a local state of mind.
The only place you'll find everything you need in the Inland Empire.
Back to Game Time, everyone. We have another special guest, our first student athlete right here on Game Time, Isaac Marquez. And Isaac, how's it going?
Going good. Good.
Thanks for coming on the show. And Nadia has some questions for you.
Yeah, well, Isaac, we are going to start the same way we did with Coach Gallardo, by finding out a little bit of something about you. So why can you tell us, when you don't have baseball on the brain, what do you do for fun?
I basically go to church all the time. I'm basically there because I'm back in the worship team and play the drums. So, like, they use me to, like, feel the spirit, and either that or we have band practice, so, or youth events, stuff like that.
Who do you try to emulate as a drummer?
What?
Who do you try to emulate as a drummer? Somebody famous, or?
No, I'm just trying to just learn to play the drums.
Now, what position do you play, and what are your current stats right now?
I play second base, and I also pitch, and I think I'm doing pretty good.
And are you involved with any other activities at school? You said you like drums, to play the drums. Do you play?
No, I don't play the drums at school. I'm either at baseball practice, but other than that, that's pretty much it.
So your focus is baseball?
Baseball, and then after that, whatever. Yeah.
Okay, now baseball players, most of them, I would say, whether it's minor leagues or high school or the big leagues, they're superstitious. Once something goes well, they stay with it until something goes wrong. How superstitious are you, and if so, what do you end up doing?
I'm not really that superstitious. All I do is before a game is pray to God to keep me in his hands and not let anything do bad for me. That's pretty much it.
That's not a bad thing to do before every game, that's for sure. Now, even though your team's off to a little bit of a slow start, what are your expectations for this team?
For the team, I want us to win San Jose League and go to the CIF playoffs.
Okay, now, who in the San Andreas League are you saying, this is the team we got to knock off to get to where we want to go?
We want to knock off everybody, just us. Forget them. We can just go us.
Okay, Coach. Now, in your opinion, what kind of player is Isaac?
Oh, Isaac is he's one of my go-to guys. He's right. He's a second baseman and a pitcher. And one of the things that is awesome about him is I know wherever I put him, if he's my starting second baseman, he's going to make every play. If I need somebody to kind of stop the bleeding and, you know, maybe the pitcher before has walked somebody or we need to get out of an inning, I go to Isaac and he shuts the door and gets us out of it. And so Isaac is a very hardworking player, and he's really elevated the level of our team's play.
You realize how much you have on your plate right now? What does that mean, though, that the manager has so much confidence in you?
I feel good. Like, it's good that I can, like, also have the pitchers back or have my team's back and not just be about me, just help them out, too.
We'll be right back with Isaac and Coach Ray right after this.
Welcome to Access Rewind.
Access Rewind will be taping each of our shows in the field at select locations all over the Inland Empire, bringing you unrestricted behind-the-scenes access and revealing interesting and unknown facts about each location.
Access Rewind, a local state of mind.
The only place you'll find everything you need in the Inland Empire.
Welcome back to Game Time, folks. We are coming to you live from downtown San Bernardino at Mardi Gras Restaurant. This is fun, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, it's a lot of fun. No question about that. And I know that you guys played Colton today. How was that result?
That was a tough game. We lost today 3-1. We pitched really well. Our starting pitcher, Michael Martinez, threw really well. And we scored a run the first inning, so it was a 1-1 ball game for a while. And then kind of got away from us a little bit in the fifth, but we learned a lot of things. We learned a lot of things, and the nice thing is we'll see Colton again, so we look forward to that.
What did you specifically learn about the result of today's game?
Well, I think we learned that our pitchers are able to do, and our freshman pitcher he went through seven innings today, and then Isaac came in and He stopped the bleeding a little bit and got us out of a little jam. And so, I think we learned a lot about our team being mentally tough and being able to, trust these guys, in these tough situations to, rely on them and put them in the best position to win.
Now, Isaac, as a pitcher, do you feel more comfortable starting a game or coming in relief and putting out the fire like you did today?
No, I like coming, like closing the game. Yeah. I like it better than starting the game. I don't know why. It's just...
Is it a mentality thing?
I think so. I don't know. It's just when I just feel more confident when I'm closing the game than starting or middle relief.
Now, as a starter, sometimes I've heard pitchers talk about that as a starter, you got to pace yourself a little bit. You got to save some for later on in the game. But But when you come in immediately, you have to be throwing hard right off the bat. Is it more of an adrenaline thing that kicks in, and that's why you feel more comfortable that
That's
way?
Probably why, because it just go like all 100% and just shut it down.
Now, Coach, who are the teams to beat in your league this year?
Well, I'm going to take Isaac's answer from earlier. I think we want to beat them all. You know, this is the first year that we've had eight teams in our league. We just got Rialto and Carter just added to the league this year, along with, you know, Colton, Cajon, Sanjee, Pacific, and San Bernardino. And, you know, it makes the league much more competitive. And right now, you know, there's not one team, I think, that sticks out as the dominant one. It always comes down to the last game of the season. And so, you know, hopefully we're there at the end and see, let the chips fall where they may.
Well, it's great to have you here on Game Time. And stay tuned, folks. We'll be back in just a moment.
Cruise on in to the California Welcome Center and let us help you plan your next vacation. With over 1,000 brochures and maps available, plan for a weekend getaway or an extended vacation. Purchase your Disneyland resort tickets. Check your emails at our internet cafe and visit Purdue Bear. Looking for that special gift for that special someone? We have a unique collection of Route 66 NASCAR and California souvenirs. Come on, cruise on in and experience the California Welcome Center. 1955 Hunts Lane, San Bernardino.
Welcome back to Game Time, folks. We are coming to you live from downtown San Bernardino at Mardi Gras Restaurant.
Yeah, this is a lot of fun. And Nani, do you know what else is fun?
What's that?
Opening night.
On Broadway?
Not exactly Broadway. No, not New York. But we're talking about opening night for the Inland Empire 66ers. And this Thursday night, April 7th, the Inland Empire 66ers are going to kick off their 2011 season. But this season is a little bit different from last year. Nadia, do you know why?
I sure do.
Well, maybe some of the folks in our audience, maybe they're not sure of why it's different, but lucky for them, our Game Time crew was at Arrowhead Credit Union Park recently to cover the breaking news that the 66ers are now associated with the Angels. Let's take a look at the new Inland Empire 66er affiliate celebration.
Today, the Inland Empire 66ers are celebrating their affiliation with the Los Angeles Angels. Let's play ball.
On behalf of the 66ers and the Elmore Ownership Group, Ms. Donna Tuttle and Mr. David Elmore, we'd like to welcome you to this affiliation celebration. We want to thank everybody with the City of San Bernardino, of course, the Angels, with the Elmore Sports Group.
It's always exciting when you have a chance to start working with a new Major League affiliate, and we have over the years dealt with a number of them, but there's none that I've looked forward to working with more than I have the Angels. It is just an outstanding relationship you'll have with the community and the fans.
We're really honored with the affiliation. We're ecstatic about the area that they covered. Inland Empire fans are really important to us. We're proud of the affiliation and welcome to the Angel family.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm here with Inland Empire 66ers owner Donald Tuttle. First off, congratulations.
Thank you, Chris. It was really a great day today. I hope everyone comes out. This is a gorgeous stadium, and now we've got just a great team.
I'm here with General Manager Tony Regans. First off, welcome to San Bernardino.
Oh, it's good to be out here. Outstanding day today.
What do you think about this affiliation?
Oh, we're excited. We're thrilled. It's good to be able to come out and meet the fans today and really start, you know, kick off the affiliation. Our expectation is that this thing is going to grow and just be one of the better affiliations in all of baseball.
I'm here with Angels manager Mike Socha. So, Coach, you mentioned earlier about having a winning season in an organization from top to bottom. Where does that begin?
Well, I think it begins on the field with the players, obviously, but there's a lot of preparation. We believe a big part of player development is winning. It has to be a component. And we certainly want those players to come up with that feeling and that philosophy so when they get to the major leagues, the expectations are understood and they can go out there and play at a high level.
I'm here with Coach Gamboa. First off, welcome to San Bernardino. What does it mean to you to be here?
Oh, I'm thrilled. As I mentioned to the fans, I've never had a job in baseball where I was at home. And in my former job with the Padres, I came to this park with our Lake Elsinore team, and it was admired from the other side of the fence how nice the facility was. And now to think that I get to work here every day, it's going to be a lot of fun for me and for the players.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you very much. This has been a really special day for us. We're just getting ready to kick off the season with the Angels. And they want to promote the Inland Empire. That's where their fan base is. That's our fan base. And for what San Bernardino has done, the ballpark looks great today, I think, and we're really proud of it. So we want to have a great season and urge all the fans here in the community to come join us.
Welcome back to Game Time, folks. As you all know, we are channeling the local sports force here at Game Time.
Channeling the local sports force?
Yes, Brett, channeling the local sports force. Yes, indeed, here at Game Time, we are bringing you all the local sports right into your living room, and every week we will bring you an on-site interview with one of our great student athletes from San Bernardino.
Yeah, these are pretty cool. And ladies and gentlemen, this week's profile of the week belongs to Mackenzie Roddy from Cajon High School. Roll it, guys.
Hello, I'm Nadia Gill, and welcome to Game Time. Today I'm here with one of the top volleyball players in the Inland Empire, Mackenzie Roddy. Hi, Mackenzie. Thank you for having us.
Hi, Nadia. Thank you.
All right. So, Mackenzie, when did you start playing volleyball, and what was it about volleyball that made you want to play the sport?
Well, I started playing volleyball in middle school, but I didn't start playing at a competitive level until my freshman year of high school when I started playing club, and then I've just been playing ever since.
Did you ever think that volleyball would open all these doors for you?
No, never. I used to play tennis, and I never really saw myself with a very promising career in tennis. And then when I switched to volleyball, there's so many opportunities and so many possibilities to succeed in the sport. And now I've committed to Northern Illinois University, and I just signed my letter of intent, so I will be a Husky. I'm just so excited for what the future has and just to play volleyball as long as possible.
Awesome. And what influence has Coach Bougie had on you in your high school volleyball career?
Coach Bougie is actually one of the biggest reasons that I pursued volleyball. As a freshman, she stuck a club tryout flyer into my locker, and I just went on a whim to try out, and then I made a team and just decided to play. And that just spiraled into me being very successful, and now I'm on one of the top club teams in the nation, and we just took second at Junior Olympics last summer. And so Bougie was definitely a very influential step in that.
And what advice would you give to students who aren't sure if they want to play high school sports?
I would tell them to do all that they're capable of. I think high school sports are a very good thing for a student to have because it gives you a little perspective on school, because you do learn how to balance your time. And at the same time, it's very fun and rewarding because you get to meet new people and you really build friendships with these people that last a long time. Like many of the girls on my team, they're some of my best friends. I hang out with them all the time during practice and then outside of practice. And it's just such a tight bond that you form with them because you're all working for a common goal. So I would tell future students, if you have the opportunity to play high school sports, I would go for it.
Hey, Mackenzie, thank you for having us, and we wish you the very best of luck as you graduate and move on to college, and we wish you the very best of luck in your future games. Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you.
All right, well, there you have it. I'm Nadia Gill, and thank you for watching Game Time. We'll see you next time.
Fantastic. Good luck to Mackenzie from Cajon High School.
Yes, that was great. So many great student athletes right here in our very own backyard. Good luck to Mackenzie as she moves on to Northern Illinois University. Okay, we are nearing the end of our show, but before we leave, we will give you the Game Time matchups of the week coming up after these messages. We'll be right back.
Cruise on in to the California Welcome Center and let us help you plan your next vacation. With over 1,000 brochures and maps available, plan for a weekend getaway or an extended vacation. Purchase your Disneyland resort tickets. Check your emails at our internet cafe and visit Purdue Bear. Looking for that special gift for that special someone? We have a unique collection of Route 66 NASCAR and California souvenirs. Come on, cruise on in and experience the California Welcome Center. 1955 Hunts Lane, San Bernardino.
Welcome back to Game Time.
Now it's time for the Game Time matchup of the week.
This week it's the battle between the Birds and the Bees as the San Bernardino Cardinals visit the Colton Yellow Jackets this Wednesday, April 6th. The Yellow Jackets are on a six-game win streak, and they'll meet up with a San Bernardino team that has a team batting average of .294, just 2 percentage points under the national average. That should be a doozy of a ball game, and that, ladies and gentlemen, is your Game Time matchup of the week.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we have reached the end of our show. Thanks for joining us as we channel the local sports force here on Game Time. Thanks to everyone here at Mardi Gras Restaurant and everyone who came out for today's show. We had a great time. Also, find us on Facebook and like our page. You can also stream the show on our website at iemediagroup.tv.
Thanks once again to all of our guests, and don't forget to join us every week as we channel the local sports force right here on
Game Time. So long, everyone.
See y'all next week.